Who gon' step, 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 step by me? Who gon' step, 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 step by me?
Yeah, told him I would be a boss before I had business. I don't even need nobody.
Saints.
I was all alone, so I ain't have a witness. Right back to the lab. Gotta go.
Are you sure? I was just putting. He said it, making no. Alright, Saints it is. Where they at?
So we gon' disinfect them like a wipe. Had that boy a big cat with no stripes. Now on the gram ain't worried about the light. Yeah, I had to go ahead and raise the feet. If you ain't rockin' with it, take a hike.
Say you gon' ride, say you gon' step by me. Spin the slide, say you gon' step by me. Who gon' step, 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 step by me? Who gon' step, 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 step by me? Say you gon' ride. Is he gon' step by me? Can't do it back, keep racks on me. Name him with, I keep three on me.
Ooh.
So you ride it. I can do everything that you gon' like. You're rich and famous, I'm living the life. Pull up in that new thing. I'm swerving and hogging the both lanes. You know I'm in the mood. After I score, I'm bringing to you. They're free agent, I give him the boo. I'm with the crew who we bringing it to. We got no limit, yeah, we on the ride. We all gon' step, we all gon' ride. Say you gon' ride.
EA Sports coverage of the National Football League
possible.
Brings us to
historic
Baltimore, Maryland,
right,
and M&T Bank Stadium.
I don't think it's going to be hard.
On tap here, as it'll be the New Orleans
Saints
taking on the Baltimore Ravens. Just about set for football. Blake Groupie is ready to get us started. And off we go from M&T Bank Stadium. From his end zone, here comes Justice Hill. And he's able to get it across the 20 to the 25-yard line.
One of these moves. Okay. What we got here?
The drive will commence with a run by J.K. Dobbins. And he's able to plow forward up to about the 29, just shy of the 30.
I didn't see that coming.
On the game's first play, second
down. No, I ain't going to do it.
That's a really good gain right there. They pick up 5 yards halfway to a first down. The only problem
ain't nothing about it.
Everyone's going to want to touch the football. Be a lot of chattering now because they've seen that they can move the line of scrimmage.
To throw is Jackson. That's going deep.
Grab that.
And it's
mad at it.
You get a sense of what this game plan might be.
Yeah.
They think they can take a few home run shots.
It's cool. We got it.
They tried it there on the opening drive, but that ball's incomplete.
Third play here this opening drive as they're up against a third and five. Jackson from the shotgun, escaping the pressure right. Oh, a Cardinal sin there, thrown back over the middle, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Marshawn Lattimore. And they have possession, and they have it at the 38-yard line. Offensively,
no, that was tiring.
Ideal start there with a pick on the opening drive.
Yeah, not exactly what they were looking for. We know that. That's
pretty obvious. Marshawn Lattimore.
The beauty, though, is it's happening early. If they don't panic, they don't compound this problem.
His progression went down.
And a chance to get back in it.
And this defense not ready for that one as he'll take this down inside the 25. 14 yards is the
same way as Tyron Matthews don't got a superstar at X Factor.
And a couple of the defenders were on skates.
I'm on Olave.
And you know what offensive linemen love about the counters and the misdirections? Sometimes you don't even have to block the defender. He can run himself out of the play if he doesn't read his keys properly.
Dang.
Throw on first down there, but it's incomplete.
Tried to catch it.
Look there, because
I mean, he did catch it, but
pocket, I thought he was going to take off and run for yardage. But what often happens now with these quarterbacks who can move, Defenses want to try and keep bodies in front of him, and I think that discouraged him from taking off. It made him try and pass downfield that fell incomplete.
The Saints first down there on a gain of 11.
As the field starts to get condensed, the defense likes that a lot because now you don't have as much space to cover, but a well-run corner route there.
Here's a first and 10 at the 14-yard line. Carr on the move to his left.
Hold it.
And now they're inside the 10 as he's brought down at the 9. He'll wind up getting right about 4 there on the scramble, and it's second down.
Nah, you can't flip it. But it's okay. Got him.
Pounded up the middle with Kamara. He pushes forward for maybe 3.
Let's get another run play.
Here's 3rd and 3.
All right, hold up, hold up. Yeah.
Now Carr.
Thank
you. That's you. Saints are going to have 1st and goal coming up as they're able to convert there on 3rd and 2.
They ain't give me no route for this dude.
They talked to us about needing to convert on 3rd down, in particular, not letting 3rd and short opportunities slip through their fingers. Well, they were successful right there.
It also tells you that they're successful on 1st and 2nd down as well to get to 3rd and manageable and make them able to pick up those 1st downs. Now here we are, 1st and goal. They've got to like what they're doing on this drive.
Come on. Oh, what happened to bro?
So they accept the penalty, of course, and push the offense backwards a bit. The delay of game, a costly one, as they're backed up 5 for 1st and goal. Up the middle, it's Williams. He'll get 6 on the ground there, and it'll be 2nd and goal coming up. Carr keeps it on the sneak, and he'll get in. He's over for the touchdown. The sneak successful from a yard out, and the Saints are on the board first on the road here in Baltimore. Groupie able to add the PAT, and that makes the score 7-0. After the touchdown, here's Groupie to kick this one away. Hill is going to take it out of the end zone. And he had no room to run as he's tackled down inside the 20. Offense set at the line for this next drive. And remember the last time out, they threw the interception. That led to the touchdown, so now time to regroup.
It certainly is, and their goal right now as they go back out on the field, a calming drive, something that takes the ball, keeps it for a while, lets the defense relax a little bit, and lets the offense regain confidence in their game plan.
And he takes us beyond the 35 before going out of bounds. That would have broken play, but it ends up being a good play. The scramble goes for 20.
He was certainly quick to atone for his early game interception. Instead of making another mistake forcing something, he reset himself and found a lane to pick up the 1st down.
From all the way up at the 38 now after a good start to the drive. Jackson. It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
Whenever I see a drop like that, I have to kind of take a step back and check myself a little bit. So used to seeing those big guys make big-time spectacular plays that when they drop one, I have to remind myself, we ask a lot out of these guys. Block and catch the football, not easily done in today's NFL.
On 2nd down, a run with Dobbins. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. It'll go as a loss of a yard, so now they deal with 3rd and 11. After 1, 7-0 on EA Sports.
What do they have for this? Third and 11.
We got that cheat code on there.
Here's Jackson. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
Two drives won't tell the story of this game, but you absolutely have to like how this defense has played thus far. They have yet to allow this offense to get untracked in this one.
We'll be in the game.
Now let's see. Yeah, the offense still out there. They elect to go on 4th and 11. They'll indeed go for it with Jackson. Ballooning the pressure right. And this turns into a nice gain with a slide at the end. A curious decision to go for it, but it pays off with a first down.
Certainly not the way they drew it up in the playbook, but that's why they love this guy back there. He sees things breaking down, and he's more than capable of finding an escape route and still getting a decent gain.
So this drive going to continue following the conversion on 4th. Here's 1st and 10. Jackson going to give this one to Edwards. DeMario Davis there on the stop.
Well, sometimes you just have to give credit to the defense. Great job there at the point of attack, holding up. They won their battles at the line of scrimmage, left him no space to try and run. Really nice job swarming to the ball carrier.
2nd and 9 from the 44. Now Jackson. Oh, and his early struggles continue. Here's another one intercepted. And the Saints will take over here just shy of the 30. Second straight drive now here, Charles, that have ended with an interception.
And I just wonder, because I don't think it's going to rattle him necessarily, but I also wonder if it's going to unnerve him a little bit. Does it lead to another one, or does he find a way to pull it together and become sharp again?
A big-time play there for New Orleans. 47 yards. What a luxury to have a tight end that can run a post route like that.
It's a luxury for the offense. It's an extreme luxury for the quarterback. Always has a great outlet and usually able to come up with a nice play down the middle of the field.
Now a first down carry. It's Kamara. And that play going absolutely nowhere as he's belted before he could get out of the backfield. On play action, now Carr. 2 minutes on the clock, 2nd quarter, 7-0 ball game. An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on 3rd down. Perry, the man in motion. On 3rd and long, it's Carr. He's going to take a shot for the end zone. And he's got him. It's caught in the end zone. Touchdown, New Orleans. A great play there. 27 yards. And the Saints have taken a 2-touchdown lead now. They went empty backfield, all their weapons out wide, so there really was no secret here to what they were going to do.
No secret, but they still had to execute it, and they still had to protect the guy throwing the ball, because oftentimes when you empty the backfield, people bring pressure at you. They manage to hold in there and successfully complete the touchdown pass.
The point after, goodbye Groupie. And that'll make the score 14-0. After the touchdown, here's Groupie to kick this one away. Taken at the goal line. And no alley to be found. The coverage was solid, and he's dropped at the 18.
I don't know what you're talking about.
The Baltimore offense at the line, set to get going. And job one here, Charles, just keep possession of the football. 2 drives, 2 turnovers to this point.
You're exactly right, Doctor. Hippocratic oath. First, do no harm. And right now, they're harming themselves on offense.
I like that. No one is mistaking me for a doctor, though. But thank you, Dr. Davis. And they're able to get this one across the 35. The drive starting play, a good one. Give him 19.
These guys have definitely never played in the first half. I like the way that they haven't panicked out there and the way they're carrying themselves. They're starting to move the ball, and what you have to do, maintain your poise and start to put together some drives.
They'll throw on first down with Jackson. And they will only muster a yard here to the 38. Jackson trying to hustle his unit up quickly to the line of scrimmage. Jackson now looking to throw on second down. And he bats it away, and it falls down incomplete. Offensively, might be thinking, what's going on here? What for their first seven throws of football?
So maybe they're thinking about rethinking their strategy a little bit right now with the way that they're throwing it around. Not having that success, might have to lean on the running game for a little while and see if they can get him back in form.
On third down, Jackson. And he will slide to a stop. He does have the first down. The Ravens moving quickly here as the clock runs.
That's good for a Baltimore Raven.
On first and 10, it's Jackson. Flush to his right. And he'll be forced out of bounds shy of the line of scrimmage, so that'll be credited as a sack. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down. From the gun, it's Jackson. That ball caught. It's Mark Andrews, the tight end. Now the Ravens going to use one of their timeouts. As they stop the clock with 12 seconds to go in this first half. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. They go play action with Jackson. And it's intercepted at the goal line. Picked off by Marshon Lattimore. And the Saints are going to have it here at their own 15. The turnovers, obviously, Charles, always costly. But, man, when you throw those interceptions in the end zone like that, it really stings.
He tried to fit that one into his tight end. And I often use the expression NFL open, which means a tighter window. Down near the goal line, you really want him to be open. In this case, it cost him.
The final shot here before half for Carr. He lets it go deep for Olave. And incomplete on the deep ball. And that'll do it for the end of the second quarter. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports.
Welcome back. Halftime over. We are ready for quarter number three. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon.
A two-touchdown game, 14-0 the score as we get rolling again here in this second half. Well, certainly not what they wanted out of the locker room here as they'll start defensively at the 40-yard line. Gun. It's a run for Kamara, and he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. A loss of a yard there to start out. That leads to a second and 11. To throw, it's Carr. They'll get this out to Kamara.
And he has a big gain inside the 40 before being dropped.
Last play, they got stuffed at the line. Different story here, over 20 yards.
And now we get into the psychology of the whole thing, because a lot of teams with a two-score lead in the third quarter, they almost become defensive with their offense, just playing not to lose. I think with this team, you got to figure at this point, this is a great spot for them to go into attack mode, really try and put the hammer down and finish this one off.
Meanwhile, Carr's throw caught by Olave.
And he gets it down a yard or two shy of the 30 before he's out of bounds. So the completion good for seven there, and it's second down.
If you run an out route, it's likely you're going to end up near the sideline. And what did we just see there?
Toe tap.
You got it. The benefits of practice. Toe tapping, foot dragging, picking it up, and making sure it was a catch.
Carr to throw on second down. That's Olave bringing in another one. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. And now it looks like they're going to be in the hurry up. Kamara up the middle. And he'll get him inside the 15 down to the 14-yard line.
Second down and six now. And now Carr changing the formation.
Flag comes in. This might be a free play. And this one drops incomplete, but I think the defense jumped. And that one was relatively easy to see. I noticed that from up here.
Yeah, it doesn't take a whole lot, does it? Sometimes you get multiples. What I always love on these offsides is when each side points at the other. Hey, you did it. No, you did it. They deciphered that one correctly.
So after the penalty, now they need just a yard on second down. Carr now to throw. They'll set up the screen now to Kamara. So they'll get nothing out of that play. And now 1 yard to go on third down. Looking to speed things up here, going with some tempo. Carr to throw on third and one. He had him. He was open, but he couldn't get it to him. It's incomplete. That close on third down. I think everybody probably expecting a run. Instead, they go to the air on third and short yard.
I realize this is a passing league, and they're liable to throw the ball any down and distance, but that short, I do question the call. Run the football and pick it up.
And his kick is indeed good, and that will extend their lead even further.
Well, they picked up right where they left off in the first half. First drive after the break, they come away with three and increase that lead.
Yeah, and you just want to keep building on that lead, don't you? Whether it's 6 points or 3 points, take everything you can get. Keep maneuvering, keep adding to it, keep making it difficult for them to come back.
Oh, good looking return set up here. And pretty good field position here. He's out of bounds right at the 35. The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive.
And really, Charles, not much of a surprise that they're losing. They just haven't been able to get much of anything going in the pass game. And as you well know, in today's NFL, if the passing game isn't working, usually not much else is working either.
You're exactly right about that, partner. And I know that right now the easy answer would be, hey, let's run the football. But that might not be everything you need. So despite the fact that they've struggled throwing it, they've got to find some type of a play, multiple plays, that puts the ball in the air and allows for them to have some success.
So the big play changes the complexion of things. Here's first and 10 just outside the 30. Now it's Jackson. Flushed out right. He'll get just a yard on the scramble. It's second down. They're going to hurry back to the line now. Now it's Jackson. And for the fourth time tonight, it's an interception. Picked off by the Honey Badger, Tyrann Mathieu. And he will take this one home. It's a touchdown.
Well, I mean, you get it. They're trying to make something happen here in this third quarter, CD, but I don't think a pick six is exactly what they had in mind.
No, not at all, because this offense, they've been stuck all game long. Haven't dented the scoreboard yet. And they're kind of forced to take a few chances here. And that one, it backfired in a big way.
Here's Groupie for the PAT. And the lead is now 24.
Makes the score Saints 24. Ravens nothing.
So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six, and now the kick is away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Baltimore offense at the line, set to get going.
I kind of feel like they've reached a do-or-die point in this game, Charles. If they're going to try to pull off an impressive comeback, it has to start right here, right now.
Yeah, now they've got a final chance to get out of this situation, but they also understand they've got to move the ball and move it fast. In addition, they need to save as much time so they can get two more possessions.
Back now in Baltimore. A lot of folks starting to make their way to the parking lot. Their guys trail big here to begin quarter number four. Ball at the 24 and a second and 11. Off the play fake, here's Jackson. That's going deep for Bateman. And oh my goodness, here's a fifth interception. And the Saints will have the football as this is taken up past the 30. The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. And after the interception, they are sitting in an even better spot with the ball and a comfortable fourth quarter lead. Down the sideline he goes, and he's all the way down to the 6-yard line. A big play there on the catch and run, 64 yards. Well, that didn't take long. One play, and we're already looking at a first and goal situation. Now Carr, forced out to his left. Now they set up the screen, that's complete. And they'll be driven back here, losing yardage to the 9. It'll go as a loss on the play, not what you need down here. It's going to be second and goal. Here's Carr, dancing to his left. Hit as he throws there, incomplete.
Well, that's a good piece of quarterbacking right there, because he certainly felt the pressure coming. The alternative, getting sacked for the first time. He didn't like that option at all. Did a nice job saving yardage by throwing that one away.
Carr now on third and goal. And give him another 6. It's caught for a touchdown, and the blowout continues. No surprise there. Third and goal down here. That's where they're going to look for their tight end.
Yeah, you want that big guy running his routes, because it doesn't matter who they cover him with. If it's another big guy, he might use his bulk against him. If it's a shorter defender, might go over the top. Either way, you tend to find a little bit of a mismatch in that area.
Groupie able to add the PAT. And this one was over a while ago as they just add on to that big lead. And this one recovered by the hands team for the Ravens. Fourth quarter, they felt like they needed the football back. Unfortunately, they couldn't get it.
And I know we've brought analytics into the game, and someone has said here that the data says that when a team's expecting an onside kick, 80% of the time, the team expecting it, they do actually recover the ball, which is what we saw here. I just wonder if that number...
All these dumb songs go, 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 just like Diego. God,